Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the nomenclature of epoxides. So epoxides are three-membered rings that contain an oxygen in it. So this is the simplest epoxide that's drawn before you right now. So I have two carbons in there, and then one oxygen to make that three-membered ring. So there's two ways that we can name epoxides. One is the common way, and one is the Iupac way. So the common name for this simplest one is just oxirane. So if you just have an epoxide and that's all, that would be called oxirane, and that is the common name. With the Iupac name, the epoxide is going to be seen as a substituent that's attached to two carbons, right? Because it's part of a cyclic system. So it would go out in front of a parent name. And so the Iupac name for this would be 1,2, and then epoxy is the name we would use for the substituent. And then there's two total carbons. So this would be an ethane. So the parent name is going to go at the end, ethane for two carbons. And then this part at the beginning is the substituent. So they're telling us that we have an epoxide and it goes across carbons 1 and 2. So this is 1,2 epoxy ethane. So here we have a little bit more complicated example. I've got an epoxide that's internal. It has multiple substituents on it. If I wanted to name with the common name, I would use the oxirane as my base name. So it's going to be centered around the epoxide. You start numbering 1 at the oxygen, and then the other two carbons are going to be 2 and 3, and you would number to give the substituents the lowest number possible. So if I look to the right-hand side, I have two substituents coming off of that, so I would have that be 2, and then this would be 3. So that would give me as my name 2,3-diethyl, 2-methyl oxirane. So the oxirane is the parent name when you name it the common name way, and then these would be my substituents. So basically the epoxide is the central thing, and then anything coming off of it acts as a substituent. If you wanted to name it using the Iupac style, you would number to give the longest chain, and you would give the epoxide the lowest number possible. In either case, it's going to end up with a 3 on it here. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, because if I go that way, the methyl substituent also gets a lower number. So my base name for the Iupac style naming would be hexane. And then the epoxide would be a substituent, and then so would this methyl group because it's not a part of the ring. So the Iupac name for this would be 3,4-epoxy-3-methyl-hexane. So hexane, again, with Iupac naming is the parent name, and then everything out front is the substituent. So the naming is the same in terms of putting the substituents in alphabetical order. The difference is that an epoxide has two locants because it spans two carbons. So you would need the 3 and the 4 to say what two carbons the epoxide is spanning. So this has been a look at how to name epoxides. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.